Hi, good morning, everyone. My name's Lindsay. Welcome to the Singing for Pleasure workshop, part of the Roses Theatre's online Feel Good Festival. Thank you so much for joining us today. It's so lovely to have you here. A couple of things that might help us as we're going along. You might notice that we have a live chat option. So, sadly, just doing this on YouTube Live, I can't see your faces. So, if you would like to give me any feedback, if you can't hear me, if the volume's too high or too low, please do let me know via the live chat, and then I'll just be able to adjust things as we go along. A couple of other things that might help. If you've got some water handy, singing's quite a thirsty work anyway, but especially in this really hot weather, having some water might feel really good as well. So, singing for pleasure, there's all sorts of things we can do when we start to sing, and there are all sorts of exercises and things we can try. What I've done with this workshop is started to add a few exercises and sounds that you can maybe add to your day at home. So my aim for us is that we'll have a few little ways that we can use our voice daily that is going to make us feel good. Our voices are just like any sort of physical part of our body. They enjoy being moved, they enjoy being warmed up and exercised. And maybe unlike the rest of the body, the voice also is a really good way of connecting to your emotions and your creativity, and maybe any sort of storytelling or any creativity that you want to get out of your system. We are going to have quite a few options with how we do the exercises. So if anything doesn't feel comfortable for you, or if anything I do or suggest you think, that's not quite for me, that's absolutely fine. The main aims of this workshop is to give you a chance to sing, to give you some more information on how you can use your voice, and to just give you these sort of beautiful small moments of creativity and music making within your everyday. So, we're going to start with some physical warm-ups. Then we're going to do a few breathing exercises. We're going to do a couple of vocal exercises, and then we're going to move on to a song. I have made some lyric sheets here, so I'll be really interested to see how you will respond to those on the screen, but I'll check in with you about those later. If you have any questions throughout this live stream, please do talk to me via the Roses Theatre chat. And we also have one of our staff members who's also watching. Hello, Claire, and she'll also be on hand to maybe answer any questions as we go along. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to get a little bit more comfortable and a little bit more energized with our bodies. So you can do these seated or you can do them standing. Choose whichever option feels the most comfortable for you right now. Okay, so when we do these exercises, the only thing I want you to focus on is what feels good for you. Okay, so if you're standing, your toes and your feet are going to be facing the front. If you're seated, you can potentially do that as well, as long as it's comfortable to have your feet flat on the floor. The big thing if you're doing these exercises seated is you want to support your lower back. So make sure you're sort of sitting in a position where your lower back is comfortable. And for all of us, whether we're seated or standing, we want to create space in this torso area. So maybe just take a moment to let that happen. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to just bounce up and down very gently on the balls of our feet. If you're doing this seated, see if you can bounce up and down your bum. It's quite fun. This is just a gentle bounce, and this is just starting to get the energy flowing through from the balls of our feet all the way up to the torso. And it's starting to raise our heart rate just a little bit, not in any intense way. We're just going to do this for a couple of seconds more. Okay, and then you're going to stop. Just let the feet come up and down off the floor. So just sort of like lift each foot in turn. If you're seated, you can transfer your weight between your sit bones. Okay, lovely stuff. What we're going to do now, and if you're doing this seated, I want you to do it with the thighs instead of with the feet. You're going to transfer your weight forward onto the balls of your feet and then slowly transfer back onto the heels. This is quite a small movement, so you shouldn't lose your balance. If you feel like you're going to tip over, see if you can make this action just a little bit smaller. So we're just going between the balls of our feet to the heels. One more time. It's kind of like a rocking motion, forward and back, and then see if you can find a nice place in the middle where you can feel both the toes and the heels on the floor. And then you're going to give your knees just a little wobble just to check that you haven't sort of locked in. That's just helping us find a more central point of gravity. Okay, so the next things that we're going to do now is a little bit more upbeat, as we could say. We're going to do a little bit of swinging. So you're going to let your arms nice and loose and floppy at your sides, and you're just going to do this kind of like rotational swing. If you're sat down doing this, you could maybe lift your elbows up and twist from the stomach. So just nice and gentle. And the reason we're doing this is just to sort of let go of any tension that you might be holding unconsciously. Very tense times at the moment, so it would make sense that our bodies might be holding a lot of our mental tension in ways that we're not expecting. And this again is a really nice energizer, gentle heart rate increase. Ooh. Okay, and if you want to, you can bring your elbows up like this. I just have to step back. And you can increase the stretch along the shoulder blades. Okay, lovely. And then just let that go. Let the blood circulate back down to your fingertips. Maybe give your fingertips a little wiggle like that. Okay, we are going to start now with some shoulder rolls. We're going to come forwards. When you're doing this, if you find that you are crunching or clicking, or it just feels a little bit, I don't know, a bit uncomfortable, can you make the action a little bit smaller? And in doing so, you're still getting that release that we want from these muscles, but without sort of causing any tension or discomfort elsewhere. So nice, gentle forward shoulder rolls. And this is just loosening the shoulder muscles at the front of the body. Then you're going to take it back so you feel nice and evened out. I'm definitely a bit crunchy this morning, so I'm going to make mine a bit smaller. And this is also helpful as well for gaining a little bit of openness across the chest and torso. Okay, now if you'd like to, we can make this into a bigger open movement. Now I'm definitely a bit pressed for space here, so you'll have to imagine I've got more room than I have. Arms coming all the way up and back in a circle. And if you can, try to remember how many you've done on each side so that you can do the same on the opposite side. Now, if this movement feels a little bit too big, you could also do sort of like an extended shoulder roll with the elbow lifted. That might be more comfortable. And now let's do the other side. This is where I definitely run out of space. So I'm going to have to do some contortioning. And do as many as you did on the other side, and the same if you're doing the nice extended shoulder and elbow one. Okay, lovely. And then let's let our shoulders rest a moment. I think we've given them a good workout. Okay, so let's just do one more thing with the shoulders. We're just going to gently let them rise, and then we're going to let them fall. So just rising and falling. Keep breathing. Lovely. And this is all really helpful for singing, because this is where your voice lives, your larynx, right here. It's connected to all the muscles in the neck, which then in turn connect to the muscles in the shoulder. So if we're kind of holding a lot of tension or stiffness in the shoulder and the neck, it can directly have an impact on your larynx. So it's good to just loosen up. Also, if we sort of bring ourselves back to that daily aim of feeling good and using creativity and music in our daily lives to sort of feel joy, all of these nice open movements, just, you know, you feel good after doing them, especially if you're working from home, you're doing a lot of scrunching over like this, or your job has you sort of like in a tight position. All of these open movements not only help your larynx, but they just let your whole posture and alignment open up and release. Okay, so we're going to look at the neck now. And anything you do with the neck, I want you to do slowly and carefully. Just be mindful of how your neck feels and what feels good for you. So we're going to start with a very slow and small head shake. I've just seen that comment, and I must admit it was completely accidental, but thank you. Okay, so a nice little head shake like this, as if you were just saying no, thank you. And the big thing that you do when you're working on your neck is we're isolating it. So you want to make sure the shoulders, if you can, stay nice and stable. So you're not moving the torso and the shoulders. You're definitely isolating the neck, which can be a little bit trickier than it appears sometimes. Okay, now if this is comfortable for you, and everyone's different, you're going to take you're going to take the neck twist and stretch all the way over to the shoulder like this. And let's come back to the center. This is a good time to remind ourselves that all of these actions need to feel good and comfortable for you. So if going all the way over to the shoulder like this feels a bit uncomfortable, why don't you try doing it to maybe, 45 degrees instead? But a small stretch that feels comfortable is going to do you more good than an extended force stretched that might make you feel a bit tense and uncomfortable. Okay, so we're going to do one more either side and you go as far as feels good for you. And don't forget to breathe. And then back to the center. We're going to use our eyes now as well. So there's loads of muscles in the back of the eyes that connect down to the neck as well. So you can get them working together. With your eyes, you're going to look down at your sternum. So that's this big bony area here. And you'll notice in doing that, you get a nice tucked chin and you get a nice stretch at the back of the neck. This is a good time to remember to keep your knees loose. Mine have just locked up. And then use your eyes. You're going to look now down at the floor and then you're going to allow the eyes to travel along the floor all the way up, whatever's in front of you, travel all the way up in the wall. I've got a wall and a window, and all the way up to the ceiling just slightly above you. So we're not going all the way back with this one, but just slightly up so we get a little stretch down the neck. And then you bring your eyes back down to center. So we want to be looking as if we were looking somebody in the eye who's at the exact same eye level as us. Okay, so we've got done the neck. Oh yeah, the final thing we're going to do now in our physical warm-up, and I hope this is feeling nice for you all, is we're just going to start to work the whole body from toes to head. Now I'm going to have to do a bit of maneuvering here, I'm afraid. So just check the knees are loose. If you're seated, just give your sit bones a little bit of a loosen as well. The arms are going to come up in the air like this, and then you're going to bring them together above your head. Now I'm afraid you might not be able to see this. I've got my palms together like that. And then you're going to bring them slowly down. And as you do, you might notice a little gentle pull, like a nice pull in the armpit area, which is cool because that's lifting the rib cage. Now I'm going to just slightly maneuver myself so I've got a bit more space. Now, if this is too much, if going all the way up is too much, just bring the arms up like this. Okay, so you've got two options. You can come to here or you can come to here. We're going to do it again. And this time, as we lift the arms, we're going to do a slow inhalation through the nose. Okay, here we go, everyone. And then hiss. We're going to do that one more and I'm going to come to the halfway position. So breathe in through your nose, arms come up, wherever you want to go. And hiss. Okay, this is a great moment for me to remind us all to have a sip of water, which is what I'm going to do. So we've opened up our bodies. We are hopefully feeling maybe a little bit taller. If we had any areas that we were unconsciously clinging onto or crunching or squeezing, we've maybe loosened them a little bit more. So now we're going to move on to some breathing. So breathing is the foundation of all singing. Our air comes up, so from the airflow from the lungs all the way up through the vocal tract, vibrating the vocal folds and all the way up out through your mouth. Sorry, let me just readjust what I said there. Vocal tract is from here on up, so vocal folds to lips. Air's coming up the completely forgotten all of my anatomy. the air pipe, wind pipe. If anyone remembers the scientific name, do give me a comment. I've completely forgotten. Trachea, there we go. And it's coming up through the vocal folds that vibrate like this. They're really cool. And then all the way up through your vocal tract, the tongue and the lips have something to say about it. And that is how singing is produced in the very, very basic way. So if our airflow is feeling a little bit tight or a little bit in need of rejuvenating, these exercises are going to help with that. And then the airflow and the breath is going to take us through the next set of exercises afterwards. So again, doesn't matter if you're sitting or standing, make sure you're comfortable. First of all, we are going to put our two thumbs together like this, and then your thumbs come down to your belly button. Now, what you might notice is that your belly button is actually about, I don't know, halfway through the abdominal area. And then if you've got your hands underneath your belly button, they will be resting on your lower abdominal muscles. Now, this is really important because the lower abdominal muscles are going to help us with our airflow situation. And I don't think you can quite see with my camera angle as it is. I'm not going to move it because it's set up perfectly. But my hands are really low down my body. And I think that's the important thing to sort of pay attention to right now. The muscles we're using are right down at the bottom of your torso. Okay, so we're going to start with just a relaxation breath. So this is just to make sure that we're feeling good and relaxed before we start to make sounds. If it's comfortable, I'd like you to try doing this in and out through your nose. If you don't like to breathe in and out through your nose, I know I do have some people I know who don't like to do that, then you can still use your mouth. But when you're doing it with your mouth, can you make the mouth shape quite small? Okay, so we're going to breathe in and out through our nose. We've got our hands on our lower abdominals, and we're just going to notice if anything changes or moves down there. Okay, so for this one, we're going to start with a hiss. We're going to go, then we're going to breathe in through our nose and breathe out through our nose. Okay, so the hiss just gets us started. Here we go, everyone, and hiss. Breathe in when you're ready and breathe out when you're ready. And just keep going in and out through your nose. Wherever you are, one more in the sequence. And relax. Okay, so that one through the nose, in and out through the nose, is a really nice way of just starting to relax the brain as well as the body. Now, you might have noticed, and maybe you saw in the video, that your tummy, your lower abdominal muscles, when you're breathing out, are sort of coming up and in. And then when you're breathing in, they kind of come out again. So you've got this lovely movement of in and out with the lower abs as well. If that did not happen to you, absolutely no worries. This usually takes a couple of tries before everything starts to kick in. The other thing as well is sometimes if we've got quite good cardio fitness, we might just need to extend these exercises a little bit longer before the abs kick in. So the key thing is just to focus on what's going on up here with the inhalation and the exhalation. The lower abdominals will know what to do and they will respond in time. Okay, so that first breathing exercise was a relaxation exercise. The next breathing exercise is going to take us more towards the sounds and the types, more towards the type of breathing we'll want to do when we make sounds. Okay, so we're going to move to a mouth inhalation this time. When you sing, you're probably using a combination of breathing through the nose and breathing through the mouth. So we want to train both of these. So now we're doing inhalation through the mouth. We're going to start with the exhale. It can always be really helpful to start any breathing exercises on an exhale because it just sort of gets rid of the air. And if you're holding any tension and then you start to breathe in, can happen. So if we exhale first, everything tends to relax a little bit. Just take a moment, move the feet up and down. If you're sitting, just shift the weight between the bum just so that you've not kind of unintentionally or subconsciously held on to anything. And just movement is always going to help you when you sing. Movement is our friend. Okay. So for this one, we're going to do a hiss. Then we're going to breathe in through our mouth. And the key thing here is you want to make a really nice small shape with the mouth as if you were breathing in through a straw. And it's going to look a bit like this. So it's a really small mouth shape. That's really helpful because it slows the inhalation down, which is going to get everything filling a bit more efficiently. So we're going to start on a hiss, then we'll breathe in through the mouth. When you're doing this, I'd like you to go at your own pace because every single person is different when it comes to how long we breathe in and out for. So I want you to make sure again that you're comfortable. That's your only goal for today. When you're doing your inhalation, that will be a little bit shorter than your exhalation, and that's a helpful thing. The only thing I want you to be a little bit aware of, and if I could see you, if we were in person, I'd be watching you for this, don't overfill. So let me just show you what overfilling might look like. And can you notice I'm starting to get a bit tight up here? So the inhalation is usually just like that. Okay, so we're going to hiss for however long we want. We're going to inhale a little bit shorter. Okay, here we go, everybody. And okay, and relax. So maybe this time you started to feel your lovely lower abdominal muscles moving a little bit more. If not, no worries at all. They will be doing what they need to do. Okay, so let's start to add a little bit of movement to this because, of course, when we sing, we very rarely stand still. We usually are bopping away or we're moving, or maybe we're just singing around our house and we're walking all over the place, or maybe we're dancing as well. So this time we're going to add that little sway, that little swing that we started with. And again, if you're sat down, you can do this as well. Just nice and gentle, but this is starting to coordinate our breathing to work efficiently, even if we're moving. Okay, so again, we start with the hiss, then we do our small straw mouths to inhale. Here we go, everyone. One more. And you can relax. So you might have noticed, I certainly did, that my exhalation the first couple of times got a bit shorter because my body was having to concentrate on the movement as well. But then it started to get back into sync again, which was really nice. This is a quick water break announcement. Let's all have a sip of water. Especially all that hissing. Okay, so the breathing exercises are giving us two major benefits that are going to make us feel good. First of all, relaxed breathing, loads of studies to show how that can make us feel a little bit more calmer and a bit more comfortable. Second of all, we're getting that beautiful airflow, which is like the petrol in the tank for when we sing. Okay, so now we're going to start making some sounds. Now, anyone who's worked with me before knows that all the vocal workouts, all the vocal warm-ups are really weird. So I'm doing my disclaimer right now. These exercises are strange, they're weird. Some of them just sound odd, but we're going to embrace that. So the first one we're going to try, you might have seen people do this on YouTube before. You might even seen people doing these before they sing. This is a lip bubble. I'm going to show you what it looks like. So I'm just going to breathe first. Okay, so what you're going to do, your fingers here are lifting the top lip. And you're lifting that up so that it's nice and light. Then you're going to imagine that you're making a kind of burr sound, but you blow air through it. Let's try that again. Now I'm going to check in. Usually this is my favourite part of doing workshops because I love seeing people's reactions to the lip bubble. So if you're struggling with this, and when I first learned these years and years ago, I certainly struggled with them for quite a while. That's absolutely okay. This is probably not a physical action that you usually would make in your day-to-day life. So our body's learning something new. Okay, so here's a couple of things which is going to help make this a bit easier. Lifting the lip can be helpful because it just makes that top lip a little bit lighter. So it might make it easier to sort of like go up and down. Some people, however, do not like the hands on the face lip lift. And if that's the case for you, try it without. See if you prefer that. So you've got two options there. I was taught recently by a fantastic speech language therapist, Melanie Tapson, that everyone's got a sweet spot on the cheeks for lifting the lip. So it's just a case of finding your sweet spot. So let's just try the lip movement first. Okay, so getting this sweet spot for you, or no hands if you prefer. Okay, next couple of pointers. I like to imagine that I'm going buh, buh, because the lips are making this and buh sits right on the lips. Buh. And then it gives me a sound that I'm a little bit more familiar with to focus on. So try a buh. Crucially, the other thing that you need for a lip bubble to make it a bit more comfortable is your breathing. So that's why we spent a bit of time getting our breathing sorted out. We're going to do this now. We're going to do a hiss. We're going to do a slow breath in. We're going to go back to the bubble. Okay, here we go, everyone. And maybe see if that makes it any easier for you. The lip bubble needs a good airflow. So if you're still building up your airflow familiarity, which most of us will need to do, it might just take a little bit more of getting connected with the airflow. The other thing as well that you can do, are your lips subconsciously a little bit tense? Because there are lots of muscles around here, they can get tense like any muscles, in which case you're going to get to do my favorite thing. Just might release a little bit of holding on if that's happening. Okay, let's have another go. Make sure you are breathing and you're feeling comfortable. And we're going to do a sound that we call a siren, and it's going to go a bit like this. Okay, here we go, everyone. Breathing in first. Okay, let's do that one more time. Let's breathe in. Now we're going to do a rev. A rev is when we just go round and round the same notes. And it's called a rev because it kind of sounds like a motorbike revving up. Sounds a bit like this. So again, let's make sure we're comfortable and we're breathing in first, and we'll do a rev. Okay, last one that we're going to do on this sound is a full siren. So we start low, we go high, and we go back down low again. When you're doing this, the main aim is that you feel comfortable. So you can start wherever you want, go as high as you want, and go back as low as you want. So it doesn't matter if we all sing different pitches. The most important thing is that you feel comfortable. So again, I'm just checking on my knees because I have a tendency to lock in. And again, give your tummy maybe a little bit of a rub as well, just in case you're needing a little bit of a tension release there. We're going to breathe in, and then we're going to do our lovely siren. Here we go. Let's do that again. And now I'm going to do just a tiny one, and like a nice little small one. Sounds like this. Which is quite nice to do as well. Let's try that. Okay, so the lip bubble, strange but fun, and quite a nice, useful vocal exercise to get everything working together. However, if you did not enjoy the lip bubble or if it felt a little bit unwieldy, here's a couple of other things that you can do as well. The tongue raspberry, which is really fun. You've got the same bubbly sensation, but everything's coming. The movement's coming from the tip of the tongue. Let's have a play. Now, if that one feels a little bit challenging, and believe me, it took me a year to be able to do this, that's okay. It's a bit of a strange one. Here's a couple of things you can do to sort of get that tongue raspberry moving in the right direction. You can just blow a normal raspberry. And then you just start to blow a bit of air through that. Like I said, these are weird, but they're a really nice way of loosening everything up. Let's have another little play with the tongue raspberry. Okay, so we've done lip bubbles, tongue raspberries. Now we're going to move on to some other sounds. Just before we do, I'm going to take a sip of water. And I hope you're all hanging on in there. If you've got any comments, please do send me a little message via the chat. But I'm hoping that you're all okay so far. Okay, so there are loads of different vocal exercises that we could do, but I wanted to do a few that would be easy to remember and might be easy to do as you're sort of like mooching around the home. So this next one is a nice mmm. So it's a nice mmm sound. Imagine you're eating something really tasty. Mmm. Mmm. Now you might start to feel a buzz or a vibration sensation on your lips. If you do, that's really cool. If you don't, that's okay. It's going to come eventually, okay? So just keep going. Now we're going to start to add a little bit of gentle massage to the jaw. Really gentle when we do this. First things first, you're going to find your jaw joint. So if you find those little flappy bits in the ear, don't know what they're called, but just in front of them, that's where your jaw joint is. And it might feel a bit hard because you can feel the bone. Now, when we do this, we want to be super soft and gentle. You're going to do a gentle up, back, gentle backward circles on the jaw joint there. Really gentle, not too hard. And now add that mmm back in. So that might feel a bit nicer. Okay, now we're going to take the fingers and we're going to do again very gentle tapping all the way down the sides of the face here. And if you find your cheekbones, which is around about there, you're going to go from the cheekbones to the corner of the jaw like that. Just running it nice and soft. These are your really big masseter muscles, which are one of the sets of muscles that control the jaw. This is also where we are likely to hold a lot of mental tension. So a little bit of a tap like this, nice and slow, can be a really nice way of loosening a little bit of tension there. Okay, let's go back to our mmm sound as we tap, multitasking. Okay, and if you want to keep tapping, you can. If you want to keep gently, softly massaging, you can. Or you can take the fingers away. We're now going to do a nice So we're going high to low. Here we go. Now you're going to add a slight sort of whimper sound. So if you've got a dog, it's the sound your dog makes when they really want to go for a walk. So it's got a bit of a cry. Let's do this together. Just a little bit more. Okay, so we're starting to get the voice a little bit more warmed up. We're stretching it out a little bit. We're going to add a tiny chew now. When you're chewing, I want you to chew from side to side, not front to back. So we're going side to side. And you can imagine that you're making like an infinity sign with the jaw or a figure of eight on its side. And this is just releasing and relaxing the jaw. Again, nice and slow, make sure it's comfortable. One more time. So to recap, we're using a nice sound, a buzzy sound. And you could do this at any point in your day. You don't always have to use all the massaging. That's just another extra feature if you want to release a bit of jaw tension. If you are doing the massaging, really slow, really light so that you don't hurt yourself. Okay, so now from this sound, we're going to start to open up the voice and make some vowel sounds. Okay, so these ones I really enjoy doing. They sound a bit like chanting. All of the focus when we do an sound is on your lips. And we're going to start with a mum sound. It's going to sound a bit like this. Nice and low, getting the lips to do the work. And again, of course, don't forget to breathe, which I need to do. Here we go. Okay, lovely. Now we're going to move to mem, as in member. Here we go, breathing in first. Mem, 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 mem. Mem, 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 mem. One more. Mem, 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 mem. And now mam. Mam, 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 mam. Mam, 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 mam. One more. Mam, 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 mam. So we're getting the lips buzzing, we're getting some vowel sounds working, which leads us to the next little section of warm-ups. We're going to get the tongue working. So the inside of your mouth, you can trace a nice circle like this. You're going to go from this side all the way up the top, all the way around underneath, and then you're going to go back in the opposite direction. So we're going all the way up and round like a C and then back round again. And that counts as one repetition. Okay. So tip of your tongue, tracing. On the inside of your lips. Okay. Let's give it a go. That's one. That's two. Three, four, and relax. Is anybody's tongue root aching? Mine certainly is. Okay, so now we want to go to the other side. So this time it's going to look like this. Okay, here we go, everyone. Two more. Oh, yes, it is quite tiring, isn't it? So we've just given your tongue root a really good workout there. Now, the tongue is absolutely massive. It's a huge muscle and it's responsible for so many things. But when we sing, the biggest role that it plays is in articulation. So that's all of our consonants, which are pretty important when we're singing. So if anyone's tongue root is aching now, mine certainly is, let's give our tongue a nice counter stretch to loosen it up. So this is fun, this one. Tip of your tongue goes behind the bottom teeth and then you push the back forward. It's going to look like this. Okay, now when you're doing this, a couple of tips. Make sure that the tongue is moving, not the jaw. So the jaw is going to open only as much as it needs to let the tongue come forward. So let me show you. Tip of the tongue, behind the bottom teeth, push forward. Okay. If we do too much with the jaw, we're just going to undo all that nice massaging that we did. So we want the tongue to come forward. The jaw opens just far enough to let the tongue out of the mouth. We'll do this again because it's kind of involved. Tip of the tongue, behind the bottom teeth, push forward. and relax. So we've given our tongue a lovely little workout, but we've also given it a stretch too, which is really cool because the next thing that we're going to do is some articulation work. And we're going to use tongue twisters because I always think it's easier to remember a tongue twister. So we're going to start by saying buttercup caterpillar. Okay. And we're going to just keep repeating it. Here we go. Buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar. Okay, one more time, make sure you're breathing. Buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar. And when we're doing that, buttercup, we're getting the lips, tip of the tongue, back of the tongue working. And then caterpillar, ka, back of the tongue, ta, tip of the tongue, pa, lips. So everyone's having a really good workout. Let's do that one more time. Buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar, buttercup, caterpillar. Okay, so everything went, lips and tongue have been given a bit of a workout. We're going to now say mixed biscuits. Here we go. Mixed biscuits, mixed biscuits, mixed biscuits. And that's a nice way of getting your lips working. Biscuits. We call that a plosive, which is really helpful. Okay, we're almost done on our articulation section. We're going to say wonderful, wow. And that's just working all your lip muscles. So let's say that together. Wonderful, wow. Now I want you to start to explore, can I say these words at different pitches? And I will just give you a demonstration. So can I say them at a higher pitch? Wonderful, wow. Let's try that together. Wonderful, wow. Now at a low pitch, wonderful, wow. Wonderful, wow. And maybe somewhere in the middle or where your normal speaking, your everyday speaking voice would be. Wonderful, wow. Wonderful, wow. Okay, so we've given the articulators a little bit of a workout as well. The final one we're going to do on articulation is blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. So we're making a blub sound, loosening the jaw, the tongue and the lips, and you're going to let the jaw go up and down nice and loose. Blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. And you can go anywhere you want with this. Blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. Just keep everything loose and moving. Blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. And then you can also, if you want to, add the blub to a melody of a song that you know. I'm going to go with Happy Birthday just because it's fairly universal. Blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. Blub, 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 blub. So jaw, tongue and lips should hopefully all be feeling a little bit loose. I must apologise. I live on top of a lawnmower repair shop and I think they're doing a really big repair job right now. So I hope that drilling isn't too disturbing. Okay, so we're going to move on to just the final couple of things now to keep the voice warmed up. I'm going to take a quick sip of water. They're really going for it downstairs. Just going to turn my mic up. Hopefully you can hear me okay. So we're going to do some hooty higher sounds now. I'm so sorry. Just excuse me a minute. I'm going to close my window because that's quite distracting for me. I do apologize. Thank you for your patience. They're having a great time with their drill downstairs. Okay, so what I was trying to say was we're going to start to make some different pitches and some different sounds now. We're going to start with some high sounds and then we're going to do some nice low sounds and then we're going to do something in the middle. Okay, so we're going to go, ooh. So you've got a nice H, ooh. And it's a bit like an owl, twitch, ooh, a bit like that. So somewhere nice and high to start and make sure you're breathing. Ooh. And just do a couple more of these. Ooh. 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 And that that's just getting our higher register, or sometimes people call it head register. That's just starting to get that a little bit stretched out. Now, these are sounds and muscle positions that we don't often use in our everyday life. So it might take a couple of these to get sort of like activated. So let's just do a couple more and make sure you're breathing first. Ooh. 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 Okay, so the opposite end, so we've done some nice high floaty sounds. Now we want to look at our lower pitches. And the song we're going to sing in a moment is more towards the low and middle area of the voice. Okay, so we're going to do a nice, as if somebody was asking you a question and you couldn't remember the answer. What did you have for dinner last Thursday? Okay, and that's probably likely to be in your chest or your lower register. We're going to work from there and we're going to do this. And hold the M on. Okay, let's breathe in. Two more, breathing. And breathe. Now let's see if we can go a little bit lower. Let's keep going. One more. Okay, so we've done our nice high sounds, we've done our low sounds. We want to work somewhere in the middle. We're going to use the word bat, as in little flying thing. And we're going to do this. We're going to go bat. And use your nice lips at a bat and make sure you're breathing as well. So let's breathe in. Bat. And you can go as high as you want to. Let's do that again. Bat. Two more times. Bat. Bat. Okay, we're almost ready to sing the song. We're going to end with some twangy sounds. These ones take it right back to where we started on the mms. We're going to go yum, 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 with a little chew. It's a bit like a Bugs Bunny sound. Yum, 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 yum. Yum, 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 yum. And you can do a nice side-to-side chew if you want. Yum, 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 yum. Yum, 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 yum. The other two ways you can do this sound is on a meow. Meow, 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 meow. And these do need to sound a bit weird. So if you're thinking, oh my goodness, then you're probably in the right place. Meow, 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 meow. Meow, 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 meow. And you can do it with an N for November. Yum, 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 yum. Yum, 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 yum. Okay, so we've warmed up our bodies, we've opened everything up, we've paid some attention to our breathing, we've done a whistle stop tour of the voice with our vocal exercises and a few technical things as well. Now we're going to start working on the song. I just need to take a quick sip of water. I hope you are sipping too. Okay, so the song that we're going to work on is a really lovely song called Times Like These, which was originally performed and written by the Foo Fighters. And then it was recently covered by the Radio 1 Live Lounge, a group of different musicians and artists. So you had Mabel, Celeste, Paloma Faith, Rag & Bone Man, Youngblood, Dermot Kennedy, all these sort of pop musicians. And the reason I've chosen this song is I think the lyrics are really beautiful and I think they're very pertinent for everything that we've all been going through in the last few months and are probably continuing to go through right now. I also like it because there's a lot of repetition and I thought to get us started, repetition is our friend. So what I'm going to do is have a little sing through the song for you. I have made some lyrics on these pages of paper over here. I did a little practice earlier. And what I learned is you have to be quite quick at changing the lyric sheets over. So I'm going to apologise in advance if I get a little bit stumbly when I'm lifting up these lyric sheets. I might just have to do a couple and then we'll break it down a bit at a time. So the song is called Times Like These. And the lyrics, when you listen to them and you have a look at the words, you can see hopefully why I've chosen this song. I'm just getting my backing track set up. I hope you can all hear me okay. And I'm going to do, it's basically like the that interesting scene in Love Actually. I'm going to be lifting these up one at a time, hopefully in time with the music. And I just need my lyrics for me as well. Okay, everyone. And if you know it, please do sing along. I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one that drives away, then follows you back home. And I'm a street light shining. I'm a wild light binding bright, burning off alone. Oh, it's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. I'm a new day rising. I'm a brand new sky to hang the stars upon tonight. And I'm a little divided. Do I stay or run away and leave it all behind? Oh, she made it. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. We've got a break now. Okay, get ready. We make you better together, we'll make a better life. Because the pressure is ever upon us every night and every day. So we pray and we will forever fight. We'll make you better together, we'll make a better life. I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one that drives away, then follows you back home. I'm a street light shining. I'm a wild light blind and bright, burning off alone. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you learn to love again. Okay, so I hope that the lyrics were okay written on those big sheets like that. I will try not to keep having a little bop at the same time as holding them. So we're going to sing through a little bit at a time. Does anyone know this song? I'd be really interested to know if you do know this one, it's familiar. We're going to start with the chorus because the chorus is the part of the song that we're going to sing the most. So if we get the chorus down, then we've pretty much learned 60% of the song. Okay. I'm just going to get us a starting pitch. Okay. Okay, so hopefully that you can see this comfortably. We're going to start here. It goes like this. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these we give and give again. Okay, let's just try this first sheet again. So after we're coming in after three. One, two, three. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. Just one more time. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. Okay, and then the second part of the chorus, we'll do a swap. It's time, oh, sorry, make sure you can see that. Here we go. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Okay, let's just do that second page. So we go lowest on the final two lines of lyrics. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like, oh, sorry, singing the wrong bit of the chorus. Let me do that again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Okay, let's just do that page one more time. Here we go. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Okay, so let's just do the chorus all the way through. Now, for anyone who's finding it a little bit low in places, that's okay, because next week I'm going to teach you a harmony part to the chorus, okay? So if it's a tiny bit low, don't worry about it. Next week, I'm going to give you something a bit higher to sing. Just for the moment, we're going to all learn the melody just so that we've got an idea of the sort of bones of the song, as it were. So we're going from the very beginning of the chorus and making sure we're breathing. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these we give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Okay, so that's the chorus done. We're going to do it one more time, but this time we're going to add a little bit of storytelling. So when we're singing, yes, it's a physical thing. There's lots of muscles involved. It's a part of our body and our anatomy, which is really cool. But the reason why we sing is usually because we really want to, and we want to connect with people. We want to tell stories. We want to maybe express how we're feeling inside. It's how sometimes if you're feeling a little bit sad, singing a sad song can strangely make you feel a little bit better. So singing can be cathartic. Singing can be like an emotional release. It can be uplifting. And it's a way of telling stories. So let's start to add that as well when we sing it this time. So whatever these lyrics mean to you, whatever sort of story you want to tell with this, I want you to start thinking about that as well as singing the melody. Okay, so you're just thinking about what these words mean to you. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these we give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Well, I'd love to know what the storytelling was like upside down. I do apologize. Okay, we're going to do that one more time, and I promise I'll hold the lyrics the right way up. Here we go, everyone. So tell your story. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. I'm so sorry about the lyric situation. I was getting involved in my own story, I'm afraid. So let's just learn the first verse, and then we're going to start to put all of these things together with the backing track as well. Quick time to have a sip of water. Okay, so we're going to look at the first verse. And what's good about this is the first verse also repeats later on in the song. So if you learn this one, again, you've learned a little bit more of the song just in one step. Okay, so let's get our first pitch. I, okay, so it goes like this. I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one that drives away, then follows you back home. And I'm a street light shining. I'm a wildlife blind and bright, burning off alone. Oh, and I do like a nice O section. Okay, so we're going to do it a couple of lines at a time. I hope you can see these okay, everyone. So we're going to do, I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one who drives away, then follows you back home. Here's our starting pitch. Make sure you're breathing.
I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one that drives away, then follows you back home.
Okay, let's just do that one more time.
I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one that drives away, then follows you back home.
Okay, so we've got some beautiful articulation here like we've looked at earlier. Way, motorway, and the mmm sounds. And you've got ba as well. So make sure when you're singing this, we've got one way motorway, drives away, then follows you back home. So get those lips and tongue working. Let's just do those first two lines again. Here we go.
I'm a one way motorway. I'm the one that drives away, then follows you back home.
Okay, now for the next line, I really like this. It changes slightly. We've got, and I. So you've got a nice little da, da, da coming down the scale. So,
and I'm a street light shining. I'm a wildlife blinding bright, burning off alone. Oh,
so let's do it from and I. Here we go.
And I'm a,
oh, sorry, I've lost my words. Let me try that again.
And I'm a street light shining. I'm a wildlife blinding bright, burning off alone. Oh,
okay. Let's just do the second part of the first verse again.
And I'm a street light shining. I'm a wildlife blind and bright, burning off alone. Oh,
okay, let's put that first verse together. And we're going to put it together with the backing track. So we've got some of the guitars and a bit of the percussion underneath us as well. Now, just before we sing, we've got eight bars. So a bar in this song, one, two, three, four. That happens eight times, but I'm going to help you come in, so don't worry. Here we go.
One, two, three, four, two, three, four, three, two, three, four, four, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, and breathe. I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one who drives away, then follows you back home. And I'm a street light shining. I'm a wildlife blind and bright, burning off alone.
Oh, okay. So I think hopefully that you're all getting on okay with this. Let's do exactly the same thing again, but this time we're just going to think about that storytelling. So whatever emotions this is bringing up for you, if it feels safe and comfortable too, you're going to tell that in your story. Okay. Okay, get ready. Let's breathe.
I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one that
that drives away, then follows you back home. And I'm a street light shining. I'm a wildlife blind and bright, burning off alone. Oh, let's do it. Here we go. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Okay, how are we all doing? I hope you're all right. Now, we've only got a little bit more left of the song to learn. I think we will go for it as long as everyone's okay. So we're going to do the second verse, very similar to the first verse. So I'm going to go through it a little bit quicker. There's only one thing which is different. So we've got,
I'm a new day rising. I'm a brand new sky to hang the stars upon tonight.
Let's do that again. These are my favorite lyrics in the whole song. I just think these ones are really beautiful. Here we go.
I'm a new day rising. I'm a brand new sky to hang the stars upon tonight.
Okay, and because it's a pop song, we like to add a little bit of variation. So for this next line, it's going to sound a bit like this. Let me just find myself. Here I am.
And I'm a little divided.
So we're going a little bit higher this time. Let's do I'm a little divided.
I'm a little divided.
And then we go back to the melody.
Do I stay or run away and leave it all behind?
Okay, so let's do this second verse. Oh, here we go. From New Day Rising.
I'm a new day rising. I'm a brand new sky to hang the stars upon tonight. I'm a little divided. Do I stay or run away and leave it all behind?
Okay, then you're going to go back to your chorus that we've been practicing. So hopefully that's feeling more familiar now. We've got one other little bit to learn, and I'm going to rush us through and learn it because then we've got the bones of the song ready for next week. So in the most recent Live Lounge version, they have AJ Tracy and Sean Paul doing a rap section in the middle of the song, which is really, really cool. AJ Tracy did some really excellent lyrics about his lockdown life, which I think a lot of us will relate to, learning to make pasta bakes, staying inside, streaming games. Now, I haven't put the rap in because I'll be very honest, I can't rap. And I do apologize for that. If you want to have a listen to the original version for this and have a go at doing the rap, though, I really fully encourage and support that. And I would certainly love to hear anyone trying the rap. So if you wanted to do a little video and email it to the Roses, that would be even cooler. But the Sean Paul section, it was some new melodies and some new lyrics added to the 2020 version. And I think that they're really beautiful again. And I think, again, very meaningful for what we've all been through. So we've got this section here. Now, bear with me. I'm just going to grab a chord so I know what I'm doing. We make it better. Da, 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 da. Yeah, there we go. So it goes like this.
We make it better together, we'll make a better life, because the pressure is ever upon us every night and every day, so we pray and we will forever fight. We'll make it better together, we'll make a better life.
So I think that's just really lovely, those lyrics about hope there, which we all need. Okay, so let's sing it through together. So this is the first part of it. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, after three.
1, 2, 3. We'll make it better together. We'll make a better life, because the pressure is ever upon us every night and every day, so we pray and we will forever fight. We'll make it better together. We'll make a better life.
Now, what's really nice about this is you've got all of those lovely articulation exercises we did earlier, mixed biscuits. So you've got make it better, and then all the T's, the, ta, make a better life. So get your lips and your tongue working. It's going to really help getting this to sound really punchy and rhythmic. Okay, here we go, everyone. After three, one, two, three. We make it better together. We'll make a better life because the pressure is ever upon us every night and every day. So we pray and we will forever fight. We'll make it better together. We'll make a better life. And what's really nice there, so you've got all your emphasis on better together, which is really important because that's the spirit of the song. Let's try that again. One more time. So one, two, three. We make it better together. We'll make a better life because the pressure is ever upon us every night and every day. So we pray and we will forever fight. We'll make it better together. We'll make a better life. Okay, so first of all, congratulations. That is all of the different melodies in the song that we need to learn at this point. We're going to sing through the song from the start to the end. Thank you so much for sticking with me. An hour and 10 minutes. Goodness me. Thank you so much. Let me just explain a bit what's going to happen now. We're going to sing the song from the start to the end with the backing track so we can put all of these different melodies and skills that we've learned together. And then for the next two sessions that we're going to have together, we will add some harmony parts and some other little variations to the song that we can explore now that everyone's a bit more familiar with it. And we'll also do a couple of different exercises like we did at the beginning. I need to have a sip of water first. I encourage you to do so as well. Okay, now I just need to shuffle all of these lovely lyric sheets into the right order so that we don't get confused. And hopefully as well, what we'll do is if you've signed up and you've had a lovely time today and you've been watching, you can contact us and I will ask Claire to put the Feel Good Festival email address into the live chat. If you contact us with your email address, I will send you an email copy of the lyrics that we are using. So you can have a copy and a PDF copy. And I will also quite happily send you a little PDF of some of the exercises we've done as well. So don't share your email addresses in the live chat because we want to obviously protect your data. But Claire, can you please share the Roses Feel Good Festival email address? And then you can contact us via that. So let me just get this in the right order. I think I'm almost there, everybody. And let's hope I can get them all up in the right time like I did the first time. Hopefully that wasn't a fluke. So from the very beginning of the song, everyone, and like I said, we're here today to sing for pleasure. So part of that is telling our stories and releasing our emotions. So here we go. One, two, three, four. Two, two, three, four. Three, four, five. Six, seven, and let's breathe. I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one that drives away, then follows you back home. And I'm a street light shining. I'm a wild light, blind and bright, burning off alone. Oh, okay, here we go. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these we give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Okay, let's breathe. I'm a new day rising. I'm a brand new sky to hang the stars upon tonight. Get ready. And I'm a little divided. Do I stay or run away and leave it all behind? It's, oh yeah, we're there. Here we go, everyone. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Now we've got a little break for 8 bars. Okay, get ready. Here we go. We make it better together, we'll make a better life, because the pressure is ever upon us every night and every day, so we pray and we will forever fight. We'll make it better together, we'll make a better life. I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the one that drives away, then follows you back home. I'm a street light shining. I'm a wildlife blind and bright, burning off alone. Oh my goodness, here we go. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these you learn to love again. Oh, well done, everybody. And thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining us. I will definitely get Claire to confirm this, but I believe this is our first live stream of a workshop for the Feel Good Festival. It's the first time we've done this. So I'd just first of all like to say thank you so very much. We're really privileged to have you here supporting us, and really, really privileged that you've joined us today. It means a lot to us, and it's so lovely to keep singing together amongst everything that's been going on. If you have any feedback at all, please do send it to community@rosestheatre.org. Like I say, it's our first time. I'm absolutely certain that there's things that could be improved. So it'd be lovely if you've got any feedback, if things could be done slightly differently. We're very open to suggestions. And we have got two more of these sessions. So that's next Wednesday at 11 a.m. and the Wednesday after at 11 a.m. as well. I've completely forgotten what the actual dates are, but I believe it'll be the 19th. Yeah, 19th and the 26th of August. We are going to keep working on this song. So like I say, if you could email us your email addresses, we will send you over some lyrics, and I'll send you over a copy of some of the exercises we've done as well. And we'll just be building up on these skills over the next 2 weeks. Next week, I'm going to teach you some harmonies. So thank you very, very much. Have a lovely rest of your day. Go and have a big cold drink of water, and hopefully we will see you next week. Oh, finally, thank you so much, Claire. Claire has been the person putting everything together at the Feel Good Festival. She has been an absolute pillar of support for myself and all of the other musicians and artists and everyone else who's doing it. So thank you so much. Thanks, Joyce. Oh, lovely. And I'm glad you laughed. If you laughed, that makes me even happier. Thanks, everybody. Take care. And we'll see you next week. Bye.